At university, you will not only get feedback from your teachers and teaching assistants, but also from your peers. And you will also be asked to give feedback to your peers and to your teachers. But what is feedback? And how do you give it in a good way? In the engineering world, feedback occurs when outputs of a system are fed back as inputs as part of a chain of cause and effect that forms a circuit or loop. But in this video, we mean by feedback information about reactions to your performance of a task, which is used as a basis for improvement. So to improve your mathematics skills or to improve this course, feedback can be an important source of information. Good feedback are reactions that help you improve. So it needs to be specific, based on observation and on your response, and contain tips to improve. Often, at least these three steps are taken for good feedback. Firstly, you share your observations. Tell us what you saw, heard, experienced. What was your response? How did it make you feel? What did it make you do? And finally, you finish your feedback with a tip. What would you recommend? Let's start with a simple example to separate loose opinions from feedback. Suppose you are a chef in a restaurant. You can get reviews like this, 4 stars, or food was tasty, or I ordered the spaghetti bolognese. The portion size was good. The sauce smelled delicious with its fresh basil, and the spaghetti was nicely cooked al dente. The sauce contained a bit too much pepper to my taste. My tip is to let customers add the pepper themselves. Now, which review would help you improve? The first two reviews are positive reviews and show you are on the right track. The last one is also positive, but it's more specific and gives a concrete example and tip to improve. So the last review gives you really good feedback. Now, feedback will not always be positive. The review could also look like this. Or, food was awful. Or, I ordered the spaghetti bolognese and the spaghetti was overcooked and the sauce lacked taste. I was very disappointed. My tip is to use more herbs and spices and pay more attention to cooking times. Now, as a chef, you might not like the feedback. But at least the last review is very specific and can help you improve. Another important aspect of this feedback is that it discusses the output, in this case the spaghetti, and not the person who made it, in this case the chef. You can imagine that a comment like, "Your chef doesn't know how to cook spaghetti," might hurt a person much more than a comment, "The spaghetti was overcooked." So keeping your feedback focused on the end result rather than on the person who made it will make your feedback easier to accept and therefore make the chances of a person improving things based on your feedback much higher. The same goes for feedback on behavior. It's better to say, for example, "I see you didn't finish your work in time," than to say, "I think you are lazy and unreliable." Unfortunately, at your university and in this course, the teachers can't always be very specific with their feedback and often return the feedback in the form of a grade. So often you have to analyze yourself how you are doing by looking at which exercises you did well and which not. But don't be afraid to ask teachers and fellow students for feedback and advice. We would really value your feedback on this pre-university calculus course, because we would like to improve our course. The feedback may be positive or negative, but please be specific, tell us how it made you feel, what it made you do, etc., and finish with tips. We, on the receiving side of the feedback, promise to listen to your feedback and be grateful. Thank you so much. Also, thank you very much for following this course, and we wish you all the best in your study and in your future career. Bye!